injured wildlife will get a whole lot easier come April. Crow is rebuilding on Sanibel. So this video, it was taken right after Hurricane Ian nearly a year ago. So Crow suffered hundreds of thousands of dollars in damages from storm surge. Earlier today, as we mentioned, nearly a year after the storm, Crow held a groundbreaking ceremony for the new enclosures to help injured animals. Tonight, ABC7's Alexia Charopoulos is getting us more on that rebuilding process.
These six platforms that are currently under construction will soon transform into these massive enclosures. And I'm told that Crow will be able to house more birds like they once used to right here on their campus.
It's really great to be able to treat a patient from the time they come in until the time they go back home to the wild.
Clinic for the Rehabilitation of Wildlife, or Crow, veterinarians have been hearing this. And they welcome those sounds of construction.
Lots of joy.
Because it's a
big milestone for us in our storm recovery and for the community.
After Hurricane Ian, this is what the area looked like.
Crow is still here.
Half of their outdoor enclosures were decimated. They had to take operations off island.
We're off campus for a good 6 months, functioning out of some buildings at Animal Refuge Center in North Fort Myers.
And since Ian, they haven't been able to care for as many injured animals.
I will say our numbers are down in terms of the amount of patients that are coming into the clinic compared to last year.
Now they're ready to change that. On Tuesday, the rebuild officially started, which comes almost a year after Hurricane Ian.
Continuing our mission, making sure that the wildlife gets back out into the environment.
This time, they are future-proofing.
Planning for worst-case scenarios, not just what can we afford right now, but what is best for Crow, what is best for the community.
That way, they can be there for their furry or feathered patients from the moment they come through their doors until they're ready to be released back into the wild.
Continue to come out, support the islands, support our community.
It is through the community's support that they're able to rebuild this facility to what it once was. And once this is all complete, they'll be able to start the sea turtle facility next. I'm reporting from Sanibel, Alexia Charopoulos, ABC 7.